We're here coming in to do the forecast reading for the 2024. This is I'm not sure if this is going to be part one or part two, but I just finished recording the predictions part of it and how, you know, things we may see unfold, the energy and how the energy is moving and shifting us as in humanity and our human evolution and our human growth. So those things have really, truly been playing through my energy for a while. And I really wanted to bring it back into healing and to energetic guidance as well. And so it's one thing to be able to predict the energy, to see how it's actually moving. It doesn't mean it's all going to unfold that way, but it is how it's looking as a seer, as a clairvoyant, and being able to see that energy. But to be able to give the guidance, the wisdom that helps us to be able to move forward, a feeling confident in ourselves, a sense of being at peace is very, very important. And so I really wanted to add that part in as well and to not to leave that out. Now, I do yearly personalized forecast readings for people, and I'm actually done now. I just completed them right before Christmas, and there will be no more available until next year. It's only a one-time deal that I do it, but this is a collective energy. And so I am going to bring in the cards as well. So I'm going to share the screen with my other camera and bring in those cards and a view, and hopefully we'll be able to see that clearly. I don't have much light happening here tonight. And so hopefully we can be able to see those cards when I bring the screen up. But there's just so much love in the world that it's hard to escape that. It's so easy to get caught up in the negativity. It's so easy to get caught up in what's going to go wrong in our world, but what's going to go right? Now, the predictions had a lot of things that are going right, but it doesn't really feel like it's going right for people who have agendas or want, you know, it's so easy for us to want the world to look like we want it to look. Like, I only want to be this way. I want to be that way. And so when we see the energy and the energy is moving, is that it's not a bad thing. It's not a good thing. It just is what it is. And it doesn't have an emotional attachment to a desired outcome. It's just, you know, it can be so much good things incorporated in those shifts and in those changes. And when we see those changes, it can also be incorporating all that we have learned, all that we have learned about how to treat each other, acceptance, being more accepting, new perspectives, and bringing it into so that we bring back the goodness of a lot of things, but healed, cleared, and resolved of the things that were never working. And so there is a lot of things that never did work, should never have been in our lives. And it's, you know, to be able to see it evolving beyond there is a beautiful blessing. And so I really felt the need to incorporate that this year. Like, I really wanted to bring that in. It's because love and light is, you know, to live and exist in that love and light energy, to feel that sense of being proud, feel that sense of being accomplished within ourselves. We've done a lot of things right on earth. We may be a little bit of a fool sometimes to our ability to trust and want to believe in something. But if we lose that, we lose the best parts of humanity. So, you know, we are designed to be a little bit naive in a way. We are designed to kind of trust until we're given a reason not to trust, and to love and to give love, to share. Because, you know, if we stop doing those things, if one person hurts us, it doesn't mean the whole world is out to get us or hurt us. And that's what we have to remember. It is so important to remember that aspect of it, that part of it, is that the world is not our enemy. You know, not everyone in this world is our enemy. We may all have experiences that were not, you know, the nicest, the kindest, but that's the importance of healing. And that's why it's important to also remember that sometimes, you know, our person that we hold hostage in our stories, that person may also now be long gone. And how we remember them is in that experience. But if we think about it for a moment and think, you know, maybe they are not that person no more. So the person I'm still being, holding on to it, is I'm being that person who was stuck back in that experience. But yet I don't want to be seen as that person. I want to be seen as so much more. So this gives us an opportunity to really look at life with fresh eyes, new perspective. If I was the world and I had to please everybody and I had to kind of make everything fit and everyone fit into this world, what would I, you know, how would I go about that? It's an impossible task. If I were God, how can I make everyone happy? If everyone was given free will to create the world that they want to believe in, to create their beliefs, to have their beliefs, how would you ever be able to make everyone happy? You can't. It's an impossible task. So it's going to be that journey through of knowing that we just can't please everyone. You can't make everyone happy. But finding that sense of peace within ourselves, finding things this year that you love to do, finding yourself doing things that you love, bringing passion back online, bringing love back in, bringing that sense of connection back and being connected to that in such a big way, to be able to find that, you know, that sweet spot within self. Because as I believe is in the yearly prediction was this light coming back on. And that light coming back on is so filled with such care for us. It's hope, right? And the sense of hope, the resurrection of hope, the sense of taking our faces and eyes so much out of being buried in, you know, every one of our experiences being lost and creating it for somebody else. You imagine that every experience that you have, that you're so focused on recording it, every holiday, every vacation, that you want to share it with everyone else so bad that you're forgetting to be in that experience yourself. And that's the essence of what our soul is craving for. It's for us to be in the experience. That is not for everyone else. It's the same thing as selling that story of selling our soul, right? Selling our soul, selling our experiences, selling our joy, our happiness, just to be that somebody sometimes. And this is bringing us back to ourselves and back to that relationship to soul and to be so connected to ourselves that we start to really remember who we are. And it doesn't mean that we still can't evolve our physical body, you know, become that who we want. But remembering that you were never the enemy. You were never, this self that was with you all along was never your enemy. You never had to eradicate this part of yourself. You never had to leave it behind. You never had to abandon it. Those were all the shadow stories. So the beginning of this year really brings a lot of energetic healing into the shadow work, into the inner child work. And it's like, are we not tired? Like, I'm feeling like I'm tired of talking about this. I'm feeling like it's very tired of, but it's like every year I'm like, okay, I'm done talking about this. I'm done being here. I don't want to channel that no more. And they're like, until it happens. And so most recently, in this year, I just got a message, whereas, you know, we don't want to use your work. We think your work is like, you know, and basically it wasn't the exact words, but basically it said, we believe this work is outdated. And I'm like, and I sat in the hurt of that for a while. And then I realized, no, you just, the world, people are all on different levels of awareness. And what is being recorded and what is being, you know, what I've already walked through, what I'm already sharing, another person may have absolutely no idea about. And that's not a bad thing. That just means we're all walking our own journey. We're all walking our own path. And so it's okay that we want to give all of the mystical, magical stuff that makes people go, wow. But it's one thing to go, wow, it's like the 360. To get all the way up here and then the crash and burn. What about all the middle stuff? What about all the in-between work? What about all of this work? It's one thing to feel inspired and go, you know, I've just awakened. So now I'm talking to aliens and now I'm this psychic medium. And it was every single reason to my why, to why I stepped myself back and said, I don't want to live my life as the unhealed healer. I want to do the foundation work. I want to be strong in myself. I want to be everything that I am, that I'm teaching. And with that, they gave me the writings. I want to exist in that. I want to walk the walk. I want to walk the walk or walk the talk, right? Walk the talk of everything that I speak of, that it's one thing to say you need to do this or you should do that, but have you done the work yourself? You know, are you, you know, have you really put that work in? And it's such an important part of the journey. And so whether it is a parent to a child, a teacher to a student, no matter who it is, a clergy to a, to its, you know, to its people sitting in, its followers sitting in a church, have you done the healing work? Have you put that emphasis onto yourself? Have you turned that mirror around? And have you looked deep enough inside of yourself and said, what about me? What is it I have unresolved? What is it that is the continual push that I need to work on, that I need to do? And so there is a big emphasis coming up of that energy, you know, into the, especially into the beginning of the year. This, there is this, it doesn't get outdated. It is like the, it's no different than the teachings of the Bible. They're all interpreted differently. They have been translated over so many times to suit everybody, to suit a certain religion, to suit a certain life. And everybody receives it differently. Everybody absorbs it differently. Some people got that book in their house and has never, ever opened it. More people probably haven't read it than read it, but yet it is in so many people's house, in your basement somewhere. It is still the number one top selling book in the world. But it has the basics. It has what we, what people call the outdated information, until you learn to read. Till you learn to read without that judgment, until you realize that it is no different than the hero's journey. It is no different than the dark night of the soul journey, that we all have a Moses moment. We all have a Jesus journey. We all have a, you know, we all have a Noah's journey. We all have a Samson and Goliath moment in our lives. We all have those experiences. And so this, you know, this constant cycle, it does not get outdated. It does not leave us. We kind of date ourselves by continually existing in the past. That's the possibility, by never moving forward. But with the way the world is, and with the energy and what we have happening right now in the, in this energy, is that a lot of people have been really truly like zombies, or have been sleeping, have been just existing, which is the title. More than existing is my brand. It's my trademark. It's the everything. And when I wrote the books, and then now there's like 7 books, I just remember sitting one day and crying. And I'm just like, what was the point of all of this? What was the point? I don't see the point of all of this. There is no point. I don't get it. I channeled all this work. I did it all. But where's it going? What's it doing? And all, I just heard the voice of God said, I asked you to write the book. I asked you to write the books. I didn't ask you to market them. I didn't ask you to worry about what they're going to do, what they're going to be for. I ask you to write them. Leave the rest to me. So sometimes we're being asked to just to do the healing work. What the future looks like, what it's all for, maybe we don't know yet. But every one of those goals you may be setting, every one of those things that you keep like, so being so laser focused on and believing that it's leading you to your best life, what if that's mediocre? What if that's mediocre to what the divine has planned, what, you know, source, God, universe, creator, what your soul knows you're here to be or to do, or what your life is supposed to look like? And what I've discovered during that whole process of just surrendering to that and just saying, you know, I don't know the outcome. I just know the what I was asked to do, I've done. I've put that work in. I have stepped there. I've done that. And in writing one of my other books called You Can't Make This Shit Up, you know, I've really truly stepped into that sense of contentment. And I had said, You know, the one thing that I had never ever done in my life was ever get married. And this year at 52, I got married. And so for 2024 is about expect the unexpected. Could be a lot of things that you've never thought you would do. You never thought you'd ever, you know, venture into, that you never thought you'd ever have an interest in. Could be even foods. You never thought you would even like the taste of certain foods. And you may find yourself adventuring into these moments and times you're like, but I never thought that. But what version of you didn't like that? What version of you didn't want that? And as I was standing in my kitchen last week, I'm just like packing my husband's lunch, and he drives truck, and I was packing up the lunches, and I was standing there, and I had this image of my childhood. And it was my grandfather was a miner, and he worked in the underground in the iron ore mines in Newfoundland. And he had that tin, that aluminum lunch can, and his thermos, and that would strap in, and then she'd pack his lunch, and everything was packed in his, he ate the same sandwiches. He was a creature of habit every day. And I say, Nan, like, are you happy? She said, how could I not be happy? I'm so blessed. And she, that was like, she was so happy and such joy in her heart as she was packing his lunches. And she always said to me, you know, you'll never be happy until you find the sense of peace within yourself, until you make peace with yourself. Contentment, Corey, contentment. And contentment don't mean you stop dreaming, but you stop chasing that you need to be something more, that you as yourself, not your life, not everything, that you start to see that whatever you are doing, you are of service. Anything that you're doing that is kind, that is giving, that, you know, she could have sat in a chair and said, that's not my job. He can pack his own lunch. I'm not going to be doing that for him. She did it from her heart. And she did it not because he asked or not because it was her duty. It's because she did it because she loved. And because of love, action was taking place. Because of all of those little action steps of love, it cultivated more love, and love grew. And the more that love grew, the more that sense of being at peace and content, that, you know, she had a beautiful life. She just didn't look out into the world to discover what she may be missing. So if there's anything that you do this year, is stop looking for what is missing in your life and see what you have in your life. Look at what you already have. Look at the parts of you that already exist. Look at those gifts of who you are, what you bring to the table, what you joy you bring into other people's lives. Bring the sense of love deeper into our lives this year. Be a part of that. Be a part of that experience. Is it a shit show year? Yeah. It sure is. Definitely. But we have been through this. We have, you know, we've been traveling through this. We've been through many storms. We're not going to stop the storms. The storms are going to exist because we cannot eradicate the ego of all of humanity. It is what we do with our own ego. It is the evolution of our own ego, of the egoic self, from that hard done by, from the hurt self, into that sense of being on the right side of love, being on the right side of truth, being on the right side within ourselves, making peace with that self, leaving that not true self of our bitterness, our resentment. You know, if we resent everything of the past, we'll spend our lives time, if we resent everyone, I resent that person, I resent, you know, that energy is not helping you rise. That energy is helping you dig another hole. It is digging you deeper into the sense of trying to push your way away from something, but yet you just keep pushing yourself deeper into more experiences just like that, so that you can always keep activating the resentment, the anger, the self-sabotage, all of those things, because it becomes the norm and the comfort. It becomes the piece of self that you use to identify yourself. Are we not tired of that now? Are we not done with that? Isn't it time for that to be done? And so this energy gives us this opportunity. It does have a lot of magic. It has a lot of that journey through alchemy. We have been traveling through. We have been tested. But we've also been in like a big science project of where it's that test to see, will they be puppets on the strings? This is where the puppets, that where the strings are being cut. The strings are being cut. The cords are being released. And so Archangel Michael is so back. Archangel Michael appeared in 2020, like landed on the road in front of my house. And I just knew where we were about to travel. And he showed me the wars. He showed me the illness. He showed me all of that. And I was teaching an angel class at the time. And I just sat down and I did have the big C happening at the time, and I couldn't even breathe. And I just said to everyone, the students, we are in for, we are in for a long journey. I said, I just bared witness to a whole world shutting down. I said, and I just bared witness to wars and to seeing bodies everywhere and guns were shooting. I said, and we're going to experience this for a few years. I said, this will not end with just getting a life bag. This will be big before it ends. It's a time of dismantling. It is not pretty. It has not been pretty. It is not kind. But it really makes us stop and look, should be making us stop and look at humanity as a whole. To look at what we've accepted, what we can no longer accept. To be those acts of service that brings us to a place that we're not doing it to feed our ego. We're doing it because it's the right thing for the right reasons. That we begin that journey. That we don't let that self that is so righteous in our views and in our perspectives that we can't open our eyes and our hearts and our minds to other views and other perspectives. There is so much more to see. There is so much more to experience. And life has so much more for us. And so as much as I know this is happening, as much as I know even for myself in January, I have to go for a major back surgery. I know what journey that's going to be to healing, but I know that I know what's on the other side of this. This has been something as a healer that I have done every type of healing for. I have stepped into everything and now the nerves are trapped and this is a last resort. And so there's just a lot of last resort things that are going to appear in 2024. This is the last resort. And it's the thing that, you know, so we're going to have a lot of moments that are like, that's the last resort. This is what we have to do in order to bring that change. This is what we have to experience. This is, you know, and it's like, yeah, do we want to heal? Do we want to be stronger? Do we want a stronger foundation? Do we want to restore the integrity? Do we want to be able to step into this inner authority, this center of knowing? Spiritual authority is so big. And it's not about sitting in a pew and a, you know, a man or woman telling you, shaming you into telling you who you need to be. Nothing wrong with religion. I don't have a thing against it. I have a thing against judgment. I have a thing that just like applies into just this common sense just tells me, common sense just tell me that it was never right to put a man on a cross, to turn women into something, healers into, you know, into something where you give yourself a rite of passage to destroy them. There's just something so wrong with so many of those stories. And they're all stories, but stories lead to action. So be careful of the story that you're telling yourself that leads you down the path of taking action towards creating more enemies, and start to bring ourselves back in and just have the courage to question some of the stories, question our own objectives, be authentically honest with ourselves. How's this filling my cup? Is this really making me happy? Is this really bringing me to a place of where I can be at peace with myself? Or am I just constantly yelling and screaming? And so this is a time of when we see the peak of spiral dynamics, David, I can't remember his last name, created Spiral Dynamics. And so there's this, you know, this journey through and all these complexes that we have, and the we and the I. And we have this activist, we have this and not political social socialism, like not that, but just socialism, like a social belief, right? Social beliefs, and where everybody kind of gets torn and fighting for this and fighting for that. And then there's this courage that it's, you know, it's brave to put on the armor. It's brave to stand in a group and scream and yell and fight for things. It is courageous to step out of the fight, to be the one person who strips off all of the armor and walks forward and just says, this is not right. There has to be a better way. There has to be another way. And if there has to be another way, I'm going to be a part of the solution of finding another way. So if you can be anything this year, don't be the problem, but be a part of the solution. Even in your own self, in everything that's within you, be a part of the solution instead of a part of the problem. Because by being in the problem, you can't hear, you can't see. It's impossible. When you're clustered in here, if everyone is going this way, I'm going to go that way. If everyone is believing this and we're just accepting that that's what I have to believe, I'm going to ask why. And if everyone is telling me that I can't believe something, or, you know, that's, you just have to accept that. Why do I just have to accept that? I've been a problem child that way since I was a little girl, called stubborn. You're stubborn. You're bullheaded. Just, that's just how it is. But it don't make sense to me. I arrived awakened. I arrived with that knowing. I've been seeing since I was a child. So if it doesn't make sense out there, I can't just make it make sense here. And so I need to know some of the whys. I need to know more perspectives. I need to listen to people. You need to listen to people. Imagine sitting and listening to people that have something to say to you that you may not like. You may not agree with it, but their why may be just as warranted as yours, right? Their truth, what behind it, their passion, their, you know, their need for it may be just as warranted as yours. And so sometimes we have to come to new solutions. There's this, that, and then there's the truth. There's this truth and that truth, and then there's a whole new truth. And that whole new truth is where the paradox energy is. Is that of where we break through the veils of illusions and we're able to see there's more than one truth. And so 2004 is going to give us the opportunity to see the veils of illusions crumble and fall, and to see that there's more than one truth, that there's many truths. But we got to come to that sense of being able to be at peace with the fact that we're not all going to get along. We're not all going to agree with each other, and we're not all going to exist in a kumbaya, and that we have to have the opposites. The opposites happen. Dualities exist. And so we are existing in that energy and in that time. Now, if I were to really, truly look in with such compassion and love, if I were to, as I look in with this sense of such compassion and love, you know, I really feel there is so much for us to be able to celebrate. And we start out with the new year. And because Mercury retrograde leaves on that day, there is a opportunity for us to be able to, there's an opportunity for us to be able to have so many things to celebrate. So I feel like the beginning of the year is going to really bring forth for us. I'm throwing the word look nugget. It's going to really bring forth for us there's going to be like some good news. I just heard this in Newfoundland. I don't even know if this was a Newfoundland show or a Canadian show. And my grandmother used to watch this late at night. She was like a night owl. She'd go to bed like 3 a.m. and get up again. Like, she wouldn't get out of bed till 11, but what she could do between 11 and 4 was crazy. Little Good News. I think it was like Sundays or something. They used to come on. It was like, and it was this theme song. It was like A Little Good News. And he literally would travel around different places, different country or different parts of the of Canada or Newfoundland, wherever it was. And he would find little communities, good people. And we used to have a caribou named Clarence that lived in Buchans, Newfoundland. And he came to town one year. And then one day he disappeared. Well, everyone had a conspiracy, like all these stories of everyone had a story. And there was such divide about even having him in town. Some people complained about him. Other people loved him. But one thing they could agree on was he was a blessing for the town. When the town had lost a lot of its industry, the mine had closed, Clarence brought people to the community. He was a messenger. And so, you know, he was a messenger. He was a blessing, but he turned out to be a she, but named Clarence. So many funny stories. And then all they found one day was Clarence's collar. And so there was a lot of divide and a lot of anger and a lot of hurt and a lot of, you know, did someone shoot Clarence? What had happened to Clarence? And it's always been the mystery, but the legacy lives on. And this Clarence was on this show. And so, you know, maybe sometimes we got to travel into our past to find the good news, to find those happy moments, because those are moments that bring back the pieces of the soul. You know, this is a year of true soul revival, of bringing that sense, bringing that self back, bringing back those pieces of yourself that are just feel like sometimes they're that you've left it behind. And why do we leave the best of ourselves behind in those experiences? Back in, you know, with someone who hurt us, and we've just left that best part of ourselves with that person who hurt us. This is time of walking back just to pick up the treasures, to pick up the pieces, and then return home again to find those treasures and to know that we have so much to celebrate just by being right here, right now, that this is where we are. We are right here, right now. That mind, body, soul connection, coming home to ourselves is so big. And so there is a lot to, we find things to celebrate. We find things to, you know, little wins are as big and powerful as big wins, because everything just activates something within us that restores that sense of hope. And that's where we're starting out. And I'm using Radley Valentine's the Archangel Power Tarot, which for me, I began with the blue box with the Archangel Tarot. That's where I began with reading was with the cards. And, you know, I say, I don't want to use my gifts. I don't want to be a medium. I was doing healing work and I just happened to be my healer. And then the more messages come, people are like, you need to put this out. I don't want to go out. I don't want to do this. And so I came into this world kicking and screaming. And I started all the writings and stuff on a journey to heal myself. I never had an intention to be anybody. I was just tired of being me. I was just so tired of being that version of myself. And I say, I can hear myself speak and it's not me. This is not me. I don't know who this person is. I don't know where this came from. And then the more I stepped into myself and I found those hurts, and I found those wounds and I stopped putting band-aids on them, the more that I could go deep into that healing, deep into just being able to bring forth the whys and just forgive myself, a sense of forgiving myself, letting go, releasing, surrender. And so with that, we bring in this energy of Archangel Azrael. And the angels are so with us as we move forward. Our guides are with us. We are so surrounded in it just feels like we're going to hear the trumpets. We're going to hear the singing. We're going to hear the love, the light, like, it makes me so excited in a way. And so this is where we have the end of a difficult situation. So because January, February, March holds a lot of, you know, kind of wishy-washy energy, a lot of challenging energy, is that sometimes the world needs to, you know, we've been chewed up enough, but we're just not spitting out the things. We're just absorbing. And so finally, when we're not willing to let an ending happen, and something happens that brings the ending for us. So it's where unhealthy relationships ends. It's where we truly walk away from the stories. When we remember who we are. We know who we are not. And so this is where we have death. This is where we have many death stories happening. It is where we have the experiences of having to see ourselves leave. It could be, you know, relationship, it could be jobs, it could be just stories, it could be energy, it could be just kind of shutting out the world, taking some downtime. One of the biggest things that maybe is a very useful tool is to, you know, give yourself that 28-day reset away from your social media, away from like having to be so regimented towards, oh, I got to get this out. I got to do this. I got to do that. And leave the I gotta, and ask yourself, you know, what do I feel like doing? What does, you know, so that you can learn to trust yourself again, because everything has been on such high demand and just such demanding energy that we're not able to work with the commanding energy. If you could command the world, if you can command your energy and just say, you know, what is it I need to do today? What feels right to me? And really, truly learning to listen, like active listening to what it is that your body is speaking to you, that you're not going to chase anything. You're going to stop chasing and you're going to start attracting. And this is a good year to stop chasing and start attracting. And as you can see, you got all the swords, you know, he collected all of his thoughts, really thought about everything. And wearing his cloak, we all have a spiritual cloak. And when we start to, you know, step into doing any healing work and traveling, it is such an honor to step in and ask for your spiritual cloak. And your spirit, other spirits will always recognize cloaks. Cloaks will be recognized. But if we're wearing a mask, of pretending, we're never going to be able to be seen, because it'll be misinterpreted as somebody else. I don't want to be misinterpreted, do you? I don't want to be seen as somebody else. I want to be seen as myself. And so then we have another ending. So it's like we're being called up and out. It just feels like it's been such a challenging time. And so we are being made aware of working too hard, overdoing it, this is overextending self. And that includes voice, when you're screaming, when you want to have a conversation, but you just can't maintain yourself. And when people engage in that kind of conversation, it is powerless. It is empty, because it is not being heard in the way of, it's not an empowered sense of self. When we are stable within ourselves, when we are set in ourselves, is that no matter what anyone else has happened, no matter what anyone else is doing, is that we can step into that empowered self to trust ourselves, to be able to stay in a sense of being empowered in our ability to communicate, to express self, to be able to listen. It doesn't mean we accept. It means we're just listening. And we don't have to accept everything we hear. We don't have to own it. We don't have to absorb it. We have to let it go and let it be. And so we're working so hard at trying to convince the world that we're right, instead of living on the right side of doing the right things for the right reason. And so there's an exhaustion. Now, I did speak of in the other part of this about the crone energy and the comeback of the crone energy. And it's kind of like, don't discount the seniors, right? It's like, don't discount those who've walked the earth for many years. Is that there is so much wisdom to be shared, and it's going to be needed to be shared. But it's a time of ease. So that crone energy is not to be the warriors and the fighters. We're not here to be that. We're here to be in the ease, to be in the flow. And also that sense of, so those versions of yourself that may be kind of what you're thinking is outdated, just needs time to be able to rest and contemplate and think about all that you have experienced, so that you can find a way to express it from an empowered self and not from desperation, not from, oh my God, I don't want anyone else to mess up. I don't want anyone else to have to go this path. But just knowing that there's always another generation coming. There's always somebody else who really, truly is needing to hear this, is needing that wisdom, is needing to be connected to that. And that there's, and this is where, you know, when we bring in Archangel Michael is, you know, it's that sense of just let us carry the load for you. Let us do the work for you. Let us be the ones who give me what is too heavy for you. And sometimes in a lot of 2024, you may find things too heavy. So stop trying to control it. Stop trying to carry it. Stop trying to break it. Stop trying to fix it. Stop trying to move it. And just give it to God. Give it to the angels. Give it to your guides. This is too heavy for me. This is too big for me. I am giving this to you. I'm going to go over here and I'm just going to go about living my life. And you do this. And you will feel when the shift happens. You'll feel when the move happens. You'll feel when those changes happen. There's a lot of moving energy. January 21st has a big one. Sometime in April, there's another massive one. The one in April can really truly be like a meteorite hitting us, hitting the world. And I'm not saying it's meteorite hitting, you know, it could be, but it's just like that. It's a real shakeup kind of energy. And it just kind of shakes everything out. We're cleaning the cobwebs out. And so a slow and steady, happy, you know, being happy feet, just dancing when everyone else is saying we got to be so busy working that we don't make time for anything else. If you're losing your moments, making sure that you got to give it to everyone else because it's, you know, it's what you think you need to show to everyone else, you're missing. You can never get your moments back, ever. So this is where we have five transformation. When we go through anything that's transitioning, you know, this is where those negative thoughts get in, where doubt gets in, when fear gets in, and when life is having endings, when we're going through transformation, is where every bit of our fear stories are activated. It's where our triggers are activated. We can never rid ourselves of our trauma response. It is an innate part of us. But recognizing what it is we're running from, stopping and really truly assessing the situation ourselves. Am I really in danger? Am I really, you know, is my world really falling apart? Or is things falling away? Is things really ending that needs to? Or you may be going through changes. Maybe it's that time of when you've never given yourself the opportunity to grieve. Maybe you don't even understand what grieving means because you've been not able to grieve. And grief may appear in your life. And grief is appearing because grief is ultimate level of love. And it's okay to grieve those past versions of yourself. But it's not okay to let yourself suffer and to live in misery. Misery is that choice. This is where we, you know, reach out, get that counselor, get the coach, the spiritual guide, whoever it may be, even if it's myself when I'm back to work, reaching out is important. Now, I do have a period of time that comes around Easter, and I see Easter bringing us to a resurrection. I have death and resurrection, and I have the death in there early, and then I have this resurrection that's coming up, and I'm seeing this resurrection, and I'm seeing this light shine. So it may be very much of when we have these aha moments, revelations, true exposure, truth reveals itself, when we kind of see the worst of humanity, but we also see the best of humanity take place. It's all, we have the elements of everything. We have the elements for the most perfect storm and for the sunshine this year. Now, which means that brings us into studying. And so studying doesn't mean always about going back to school. Life is our school. And we're here to unlearn, to learn again. And so this is where there is an unlearning to relearn again. So we're learning again. There is a new level of being able to study people, study your own behavior, your own action. Nothing will teach you any more in life than studying you, studying the whys behind you, to your own behavior, to everything that is happening within your life. And this is also where we start to bring in wisdom. From everything that you have experienced, as we come into spring, I feel like as spring hits, as all the seeds that were planted last year begin to sprout, is that, you know, you get these, a pep in your step, a shift, a change that's happening. And so I do feel like there is much of this things that is happening. Now I do have a Knight of Air happening here, and so this is where a driven direction, and I just feel like a real driven energy is coming in here. And I was just looking at the red, the cardinal. I feel like guided by spirit, unicorn energy, right? Like that magical energy. I feel like the alchemy of life, like I feel like the magician card should really show up right here, that there is this like transition, this change is like go time is coming. And so for a lot of people, that may be when you find yourself in really, truly committing to your dreams, but not being so dead set on exactly how it is, but being open to possibility. It may be where you finally make the decisions to sign legal papers. It could be, you know, start a new job. It could be changes, could be marriage, it could be divorce. It could be any of those things, but it's like you sign the dotted line and you dot the I and you say, that's it. So you may be someone who picks up a contract. It could be a big offer coming in. A lot of excitement is where people get seen. It's where people get seen. It's where people get noticed. It's where people, and so you're always being reminded here of remember where you have been so that when you get to where you're going, you appreciate where you are. You appreciate every bit of what you have. You appreciate what you're getting from this experience. You appreciate you really appreciate what it took to get to this point. So you don't let arrogance back in, so that we don't bring in the unhealthy sense of ego again. So ego is going to be, you know, really, truly testing and challenging this year. As we move through the cycles, and of course the moon energy, also tying in here. And so, you know, often when you look at who you are in your sun sign, what is it? I just heard this from an astrologer, you know, is who you are in your sun sign. I think this is the way it went. I don't know for sure. Don't quote me. I could have it wrong, but it's like your sun signs can possibly represent, you know, the qualities of your, it represents the qualities of your dad that you may have. And the moon represents the qualities of what you have from your mom. And so we all have these, you know, so it's like, I don't want to be anything like my mom, or I don't want to be anything like my dad. Well, we're all going to be a little bit like the people in our lives. And so finding the nuggets of that and appreciate it. And as I said, this is a year where giving and receiving is an absolute must. We have a six coming in here. And so, you know, that what you do good for yourself, what you do good in self-care, really, truly does reflect out. When you start to embody that sense of light, being kind to yourself, you want to be kind to others. You want to be able to share with others. And it's where we start to bring community back in. This is where we start to really, truly want to be a part of a community, to be a part of something. That desire to be with people, to be amongst people, to bring people together, to more benefit concerts, I see benefit concerts. I see having like big gatherings, but being aware that whatever you're attending should probably align to what you believe in somehow. And I just see like, I feel like there's another big concert in Vegas that is going to be a benefit concert of some sort. And it's kind of like the healing of the whole experience that happened in Vegas a few years ago, and bringing back in around. Now, fall does bring us, right? And so fall brings another transition, another change of season comes in here. And so sometimes we can be, you know, we kind of can be so sad that summer is leaving, right? And often when we have to invest a lot into our future, when we have to invest into projects, it feels like we're depleting ourselves. But it's all going to be in perspectives and how you look at it, how you look at life, what you're looking at. Are you looking at what you're investing in, or are you looking at what it's costing? Everything comes at a cost, right? Everything comes at a cost. And so it's, you know, when I wrote More Than Existing and it was like, I'm done, I'm finding joy and happiness no matter the cost. And I was like, it cost me everything that I could afford to lose. And now I'm investing. It's like, it cost me all the things that I could afford to lose. Maybe the things that are going out are the things that you can afford to lose, so that you can start, when you can start accumulating, you're not accumulating junky thoughts. You're not accumulating junk. You're accumulating the things that are investing into you, investing into your future. And so don't let emotions run wild in the fall again. It just feels like it could be because there's so many ups and downs this year. So many ups and downs this year. So many back and forths. And, you know, this sense of later in fall, it does bring us like exciting news. We get kind of like refreshed news. And I love how the dragon grows here. And we are in the Chinese astrology, it is the year of the dragon. And so there is this dragon energy. There's a powerful force that is just moving the energy. It is where our passion, our desire starts to come in. The world feels like it's coming to life again, like the lights are coming on. When we hit like next Christmas, I feel like it's like people want to say Merry Christmas again. People are losing that sense of needing to be politically correct, to be, you know, socially engaging and to be so content and happy and not be afraid to speak or to say things that are never meant to be in any way offensive. They're just, you know, they're being true. And there's just a truth and an authenticity. It's like this new generation. And we see the light bringers, the light bearers starting to step up. The bringers of the light. The, you know, the next stage of volunteers that are here upon this earth. Just coming in and being the light and being the change. And to be an elder and to be able to bear witness to new leaders coming in, new guides coming in. And to be able to be a part of this and to be a part of that world. And if you're just, you know, young and new, not everybody's here to be awakened, and that's okay. If you just enjoy the fun of just listening and you're just happy to live your everyday life and don't really give a shit about anything else that's going on, what's wrong with that? There is nothing wrong with that. If you're content with going to work and doing your 9 to 5, who cares? If that's what makes you happy, do you. Right. And do that with such passion that it fills your heart, because that's where the contentment is. That's where the contentment is. And so as we see the world begin to evolve, see the world change, as we see the days for lives unfolding, is that, you know, there will be those sparks of fear. What if I'm doing the wrong thing? What if this is not right? Because there is so much changing and transformation that's happening throughout this year that, you know, you may want to see what it looks like. You may want to see what life looks like. Those moon phases, those moons are going to challenge you this year to really, truly grow spiritually, emotional, leveling up. And it's very important to level up. When we're leveling up, we kind of want to go back to the foundation. There's more people in the bottom than there is sometimes in the top. And so trust and faith and, you know, just releasing that sense, worry solves nothing. Worry solves nothing. So it is a lot of unwarranted fear that comes in, and fear is the trickster energy. So you will experience trickster energy that is coming up and around you this year, right? And it's like, it does exist, but you got to remember the seeds that you planted of hope and faith and knowing, because those seeds are the things. This is also the year of where when you water what you water the things that you want to see grow, and you let the things that need to die, die. Water the things that you want to see grow and let the things die that need to die. And because this is where from the ashes will be the phoenix moment. Of course, there will be phoenix moments. We're in a massive dragon energy. And with this, you know, it just brings that sense of the strong masculine. I've said this in the other one too, I speak about. It's the strong sense of masculine energy and being able to draw up from source, draw up from Mother Earth, draw up from the universe, draw up from God, draw up or into, and just pull out our sword, our spiritual sword, that doesn't do harm. It just cuts the cords of all the attachments so that we're not a puppet on a string to our fears, to our insecurities, to the past, to anything outside of ourselves. We become independent with this sense of, you know, the sense of liberation. Sanctified is coming up to me. The sense of being freed from the past and just a knowing. There's just a beautiful knowing as we are moving forward, that, you know, if you chase the, what is this saying? This is a philosophical thing, not mine. If you chase the butterfly, if you're chasing the butterfly, you'll always be, you're always never be able to capture that butterfly. But if you're patient and you plant the garden, you'll exhaust yourself chasing the butterfly. But if you sit and plant the garden and just sit and wait and observe, the butterflies will come. Good things will come. Good things are coming. And to not to be distracted, to not to let that little mind lead you out and away from opportunities that are coming in, because there's a lot of great opportunities. And it's so easy to talk ourselves out of the good things and talk ourselves into the things that just keep feeding the old brain, that keep us back into the knowing of the comforts of what was instead of what could possibly be. It is totally the year to walk into some big unknowns and to be very aware of the eye of the beholder. It's, emotions have been guiding us for long enough. And this is the year to begin to let ourselves be moved by spirit, guided by spirit, to recognize that we all have all sides of ourselves, the good, bad, and the ugly. It's not just somebody else who has it. It's not just somebody else who's that way. We all have it. We're all capable of it. But because we're all capable of all things, we're all capable of being love and light and to be the good, to be the change that we wish to see in our worlds. And this is a year of that. And this is a year of where we cross that bridge. We cross over the hurt. We open up the heart. We open up the back door and we let the child within be free. We let all versions of ourselves free. We let die the things that need to die so that light and love can rise. And if you notice that card, it is also a 5. So it's a year of big transformation and it is in the crone energy. But only our authentic, truest of selves is what should be walking in to 2024, into 2025, into 2026. And you know what we do this year will truly dictate how we start to show up into our following year of 2025. I send you so much love. Thank you so much for being here with me once again. If you love these videos, please subscribe. There is 2 parts to this video. One will be listed as part 2. I think I'm going to make this one the part 1. So, this is going to be part 2. And the other one will be, no, I can't even edit this out. I'm sorry. I'm listening. This is going to be part 1. This is going to be part 1 and there will be a part and there is the part 2 as well. I want to share this one first because the other one does kind of, it is more prediction work and this is more guidance. So I send you much love. The angels, the guides are with you. Be true to you. And just know that you are worth putting the work and effort into. I send you so much love. Much love. Bye-bye.